Hi all, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we got Eddie Stobart. Issues 115 to 118. There we go, brilliant. Now I have took the front panel off, as you can see. 115, we have these two side supports. And then we'll have a look at 116, 17 and 18 as we go on with the build. So without further ado, let's get on with the build. So stage 115, we have the front trailer supports. Power supplied left and right, add them on, 14 screws all together, all DD01, and then we can pop it back onto the trailer. Excellent stuff. And coming in the next issue, trailer floor joists, 4 of them and 2 of them. They must be slightly different, but without further ado, let's get on with the build. Okay, now, here are the parts, let's get them out. There we go, those are the supports. As left, it has a little L just inside there. Yeah, you can just see that. So has that got an R in it? Yeah, it does. There we go, finally. Excellent stuff. Right, so we need that there, that there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws all together. And that should fit there like that. Same as that one will fit there. Well, first of all, we'll flip this over and we'll get the screws into place. So we need 7 DD01 screws, which are all out of the bag. There we go, a little bit of oil. There we go, that's the first support in place, looking grand. Now we need this one, put that on there like so, and again we just need 7 screws get them, there you go, 2 here, 1 there, 1 there, 1 there and 2 there. Excellent. Okay, looks like I have got a dodgy screw hole there. There we go, that's that screw hole a little bit clogged up. It's now free, so the screw will go in no problem. Let's get this back on again. There we go, all 14 screws in place. Just one dodgy one there, but it's fully tightened, it's not loose at all. Now we can pop this back onto the trailer. We've got the 2 screws here and here. So the panel goes here and here. There we go, just like that. Get the screws into place and that will hold itself nice and bonny. There we go, excellent stuff. Brilliant, there it is, back in place, them 2 supports. Excellent. Let's flip this around, there you go. Looking brilliant. Probably needs a bit of a wipe now. Bit of oil on it here and there. Well, that's fantastic. So the only problem I had was this little screw going in. But it's in place now, it's tight as a drum. Brilliant, let's move on to stage 116. Okay, now stage 116. We have part supplies, 6 more joists are fitted across the chassis of the trailer. So we have front trailer floor joists times 4, 5th and 6th trailer floor joists, and 13 DD12 screws. There we go. Note that the 4 joists are step notches at the points where the joists are fitted to the chassis. These parts are labeled B. There we are, circled there. And fitted at the front of the trailer, the remaining two joists are part numbers 11602, labelled A. Excellent, so we'll get them fitted into place. So there we go, there's the first four, and then we have the second, well, the fifth and sixth one. There we go, that is what we're left with. Okay, no, let's get on with the build. Here are the parts. So there's the screws, DD12, we get them out. And that's A2 on it. That one has A2 on it. That must be the fifth and sixth one. Yeah, that one's got a B on it. That has a B on it. That has a B on it. And that has a B on it as well. You can just about see that B. There we go. All the way around. It's even better, isn't it? So I do these four first, and them two last. Okay, the only difference between these four and the other two are the cutouts here and here. There we go. See the difference there? Excellent. So I'll pop that one on there. There. And the last two go here. And here. Now, I'll speed this up, get all these screwed into place. Excellent, there we go, there we go, that's all six floor joists in place. Excellent, let's move on to stage 117. So here we have stage 117, the roof strut. So basically we link all these together with these pieces here. Trailer roof strut times 4, central roof strut connectors times 3, end roof strut connectors times 2, DP15, DP05 and DD12 screws. There we go, so we'll pop the strut together and then we'll put the trailer door on. There we go, put the trailer doors on. Take the door assembly from issue 91 and check that all the screws on the back of the tailplate 9101 are fully screwed in. There we go. Check the holes and pegs in the recesses on the tailplate 9101 and the bottom part of the door assembly 9003. Note the screw sockets, yellow arrows and pegs circled in white which fit into corresponding features at the end of the chassis. There we go. So that's straightforward enough. Two DD12 screws. Fit the bottom frame of the trailer door to the end of the chassis beam with two DD12 screws. There we go. And we're fitting another further two DD12 screws circled in blue. There are the for the tailplate. And then we put the roof strut in place. And that is what we're left with. Excellent. And coming in issue 118, side frame for the trailer chassis. So without further ado, let's get on with the build. Okay, up here are the parts. Okay, upload the parts. These four are 11701, and in here these three brackets here are 11702, and the others are the end brackets, which are plastic. These are metal, so the end brackets are 11703, and we have DP15, DP05 and DD12 screws. Okay, all we need to do is to link these up with one of these brackets. So that will go there like so, and that will go there like so. These are all identical, we just link them up as we go along, and we need the DD12 screws. So first of all, we'll get that one in there. That's that one nicely fixed into place. That one there. And we do that all the way along. There we go. That's that one. And again, there and there. That one likes to roll around. And again, four more DD12 screws. There we go. That's them four pieces all connected together. These metal brackets. Now we just need the end pieces, which also go there. But we need a DP15 screw. Two off, of course. There we go. Excellent. There we go. That's that roost job. Bendy, but what we need to do is to pop it onto the. But we need to get the rear door on now. Okay, I'm now position this so we can have a proper look at this. Now, there are four pegs, 1, 2, 3, 4, that fits into this back floor joist here and here. And also, that peg there and this peg here fit in between there and there. These two line up here and here, and them two line up there and there, and that is where we put the screws. So we get all that lined up, and we can't really go wrong. Is just pushing it into place. It's that one. Up there. Make sure I don't push it off the desk. Line that up there. And line that one up. That should go there. That will go there. Now it's just a case of getting the screws into place. 1, 2, 3, 4 screws. Okay, let's get the first screw in. There we go. That's that nicely in place. Then we need the second one. There we go. Those pegs going into that rear joist can be a little bit tight, but it's in place now. There we go. Just two more out on the bottom. That's that held in place. There we go. Right, that is the back view. So them four screws are in place. That is nicely in place. I'll show the over. There we go. All nicely in place. That floor joist with those four pegs were a little bit awkward because they were quite tight and wasn't allowing it to win properly. Or easily, I should say. Excellent. Let's put the roof strut in place. Okay, up. Here we have the roof strut. So pop that in there, and the other end will go into the front end of the trailer. Yep. Now we need to screw this with one DP05 screw. Get that in place. There we go. I'll flip this round for you now. Okay, now I've turned it round. This is not easy to film this, to be honest. Put another DP05 in at this end. This is at the front. There we go. There we go. Let's straighten that up. No problem. Boing boing. There we go, guys. That is in place. So one screw here and one screw here. DP05 screws. Well, that looks brilliant. You can see we've got some more. Looks like more, not floor joists, but more struts going across for the curtain. Now we'll get on with issue 118. Okay, up stage 118, we have the side frame for the trailer chassis. So we basically link these two pieces up with that bracket, and then there we go. Note that they connect to 118-03 shaped differently on each side. One side is sloped top right, and the other side has a ledge or step middle right. The recesses in the side frames are shaped to match the shapes bottom right. There we go. So we just have to remember that. Excellent. And when we get them put together, there we go, we can pop it on to the side of the trailer. There we go, that's a DP15 screw, DD12 screw, so there's a mixture of screws in there as well. And that is what we're left with. There we go, like you can see that's short. With the brackets facing upwards. Excellent. And there we go. Coming in issue 119, rear right side frame. So same again next time round. Excellent. Let's get on with the build. Here we have the parts. Okay, those are the parts. Now going to this bracket. We can see that side is sloped and that side has a step. That was the step side, that was the slope side. So the bracket, as you can see, there we go. See the step and the slope side. So that will go there like that. And the other will just fall on top. We need DD12 screws. There we go, that's that nicely in place. Now we just need to pop it on to the trailer. Okay, here we have that side frame, two DD12 screws, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 floor joists. It's just a matter of lining up the holes, and then we can pop the screws into place. The floor joists take DP15 and these N2 DD12 screws. Is that in place? There you go. That should fit nicely. Okie doke. Let's pop a screw in. Get one in the middle first. That's a DP15 screw. There we go. And these are DD12 screws at this end. There we go, the rest are all DP50. There we go, that is the side. You can see the groove on top, it's where the curtain will reside. And there's an overhead view, there's a groove, lovely jubbly. There we go guys. Hello. That is one long trailer now. I would like to get this back on the shelf now. Lots of screws, but it's all in place. Looking fantastic. There we go, there's the rear doors. Move that out of the way just so you can see me clearly. Excellent. So I'm doing 15s for 118 complete, Eddie Stobart. Next month we have the other side of this rear side frame. And we've just got obviously that side again and this side again, and that will be complete. We'll obviously have pieces for the top here, and then we've got the curtain. I don't think there's much else really that we can add to it really. Once we connect it up to the cabin, it'll look absolutely superb. Well, that is looking fantastic. There she is. And the doors open nicely. Excellent view. Anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month for the next 4 issues of the Eddie Stobart truck build. And with Twiggy, of course. Brilliant. Thanks for tuning in and watching. Stay safe. Bye for now.